evening so early? Aren't you going to stay for breakfast?
Oh, please. You're...
What's all this?
Well, you're sitting on my...
Oh, excuse me. Very pretty, rose point lace. What, no girdles? Wait a minute.
Oh, please, I'm in an awful hurry.
Don't let that get away, Parker.
Murphy's already at Grand Central.
Tell him I'll meet him at the bus terminal.
But you'll miss your train, sir.
I'll miss something better if I catch it.
Oh, a Gibson.
Yeah.
Number three.
Oh, pardon me. You left this in the car.
My name is Sue.
I wonder how that got in my car.
Nita, I want to make a telephone call.
All right, darling. I'll get something to read.
All right. Lackawanna 77200.
Lackawanna 77200.
Hello.
Hello, who is this? This is the porter at the bus terminal. Say, porter, will you page Miss Fleming for me, please? You might find her at the information desk.
Yes, sir. Call for Miss Fleming.
I'd like to apologize.
Miss Fleming?
Here.
You, Miss Fleming?
Yes.
Telephone.
Telephone?
This way, please.
Hello? Oh, Steve. Well, aren't you coming?
Listen, dear. I'm in a spot. Well, I'm with someone I can't shake.
Well, where are you?
I'm right here in the station, just two booths away from you. Well, dear, it's a woman. Now, don't go haywire. Of course I love you.
Well, when are we going to get married?
Listen, dear, will you just leave that to me? Have you got any money with you? We'll buy a ticket for San Francisco. Get on the bus, but keep out of the picture until I can explain.
Say, boss, if you're going to California, you better take some new shoelaces.
I'm riding, son, not walking.
Thank you.
What time does the bus leave, dear?
Right away, I believe. Let's go easy.
Ah, gee, May. That's your whole fare to California. Listen, there's so little money in New York, I hate to take any away. But what are you gonna do? A girl can't summer way to the coast. Can't what? Summer way. Oh, you know, give the guys the thumb. The guy don't live there to be satisfied with just a girl's thumb.
Excuse me.
Poughkeepsie?
Yes.
Bus number three.
Come on.
Two tickets to San Francisco. Oh, hello, Murph.
I'm afraid I'll have to suck you in the jaw.
Well, hurry up and get it over with, because we're going to California on the bus.
And I say we're going on the train. My orders is to keep you away from women. So what?
So, we're going to California on the bus.
But I got orders from your father to land you up at that lumber camp.
I don't know why a lumber camp. I can't even whittle. Take the bags, Parker.
Yeah, now wait a minute, Parker. You carry your own bag. It'll do you good. No, you don't.
Take this one.
I'll make a man out of you yet.
Parker.
Yes, sir.
Tell the young ladies I had to leave town unexpected.
Come on, let's get going.
Okay, an old bag. It's going to ruin us socially.
Hello, big boy.
Hiya, babe.
You're the driver of this prairie schooner?
Yeah.
Fate seems to have thrown us together.
Ain't fate great?
But listen, I'm broke and I got to get to California. What are you going to do about it?
Sorry, sister. I only go as far as Rochester.
Oh, but I'm awful good company. What do you say?
Okay, babe. You're as good as in Rochester right now.
Going west?
Uh-huh. You know what Horace Greeley said.
Oh, yes. Give me liberty or give me death. What was that Paul Revere?
I don't know. I think it was Barbara Fritchie.
Correct. Any information you might want along the trip, just come to me. I know every hole in the road.
Well, you made the trip before.
Well, I've read all the circulars. Well, let's get aboard, friend.
All aboard.
Thanks, Mert. Pardon me. May we offer you our knife?
Thank you.
Do you mind thanking my companion, Mr. Murphy, too? You see, the idea is mine, but the knife is his. Go on, thank the man.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Oh, allow me.
Oh, please don't bother.
No bother at all. Well, when you finish reading this book, look me up, will you?
Commencing, huh?
I just want to help a young girl turn over a new leaf. Mr. Cook of Cook's Tours.
Anything you want to know, just ask me. I know every hole in the road.
I wish he'd crawl in one and pour it over him.
Steve, do you know that girl?
What girl?
I could swear she was looking at us through her mirror.
I never saw her before in my life.
You wouldn't double-cross me, would you, Steve?
Nita, you're the most suspicious woman.
Just don't two-time me, that's all.
Poughkeepsie.
lost, return to 14 Grand Street, Poughkeepsie, New York. Holy mackerel, you want to go to Newark, New Jersey.
Poughkeepsie. Poughkeepsie, huh? Poughkeepsie.
Timothy O'Hara, beloved husband, and that's mine. Ida Collins, beloved wife, that's yours. Samantha Underhay, beloved...
You needn't check. I'll take the women.
Right.
I'd like to speak to Mrs. Collins, please.
Mrs. Collins? Why, Mrs. Collins...
All right, Walter. Is there something about Mrs. Collins?
Yes, I'm from the Bible Association. Mrs. Collins ordered this Bible.
But my wife has passed away.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I sympathize with you from the bottom of my heart.
Thank you.
Well, then, of course, you won't want this.
Oh, wait. If she wanted it, I'm going to take it. How much is it?
$25.
Come inside. I'll give you a check.
How do you do?
Oh, I suppose you're the undertaker that's come for the money for that casket.
No, madam, I'm from the Bible Association. Mr. O'Hara ordered this Bible.
Mr. O'Hara is dead. Bible. Sure, if he's gone where I think he has, it's a cake of ice he'll be needing.
Mr. O'Hara is dead.
Well, if he ain't, we played him a dirty trick. We buried him.
What will I do with this? Mr. O'Hara wrote a personal letter ordering it.
He wrote you a personal letter?
Yes, madam.
I'd go on with you, or I'll call a cop. Tim O'Hara could neither read nor write. He signed his name at the next.
Come on, kid. Let's go in and eat.
No, I'm not hungry.
Pardon me.
It seems Murph, I'm stuffed.
Well, I'll be a monkey's uncle.
Now, Murph, was that nice?
Huh?
Never a thought of the young master.
Master? The young master can find a place down there at the end of the counter.
But so far from those that are near and dear to him.
Baloney.
Baloney? No, lamb chops.
Lamb chops.
Chocolate malted milk, please.
Chocolate malted milk, please.
Do you want lamb chops and a chocolate malted milk?
Yeah.
Oh, excuse me.
Miss Fleming, you've got me worried about what you're worried about. Now, I don't want to brag, but I have some small local reputation for relieving young girls of their worries.
Or worrying them further?
Now, how can you say that about little Norm? Well, if you can ever use me, just let me know. 24-hour service. You know where to find me. Right across the aisle. I'll leave a light on the porch.
Bus leaving for Albany, Rochester, and Buffalo.
House guards, souvenirs of the trip, colored views of all points of interest. Send them home to your friends, only 10 cents a package. House guards?
Scenic views?
No.
Oh, lovely city Poughkeepsie, founded in 1800 by the Poohs. James Pooh and his brother Pooh-Pooh. Picture postcard?
No.
Well, how about your apples, oranges?
Candies and nuts to you, Murph.
Apples, oranges, candies?
I don't care for any apples or oranges.
I would have brought a watermelon, only I couldn't carry it. I have all the latest magazines. American Mercury, Whiz Bang Ballyhoo, all high-class reading. Megan and Mr. Dilch are very funny this month. Vogue and College Humor.
May I sit here with you? I can see this young man is annoying you.
Why, of course.
Fruits, candies, and nuts to you. Don't be disrespectful, Murph.
One suffers so many annoyances traveling alone. You are traveling alone. Aren't you?
Why, yes.
Going west? going to California. Are you?
Well, I really don't know yet. You're from New York, aren't you? I got on there.
You know, I couldn't help seeing you look at me through the mirror. I thought that you knew me. Perhaps we'd met before.
Why, no, I don't think I've ever met you.
Ooh, chewy, chewy, chewy.
You're a bottle baby?
Yeah.
So am I. Oh, attention, folks. Say, did anybody lose a roll of money with a rubber band around it?
I did.
Well, here's the rubber band.
What?
Say, would you like a snort?
Sure.
Albany, next stop. Albany.
We're pulling in. You better get your things together.
Wait a minute, Steve. I didn't get your name, dear.
Sue Fleming.
I'm Nita Borden. Miss Fleming, I want you to meet my husband.
Why, Steve.
I do believe she thought we were a pair of runaway lovers. Goodbye, Miss Fleming.
Albany, 2 hours stopover.
Why didn't you tell me you had a wife?
Darling, I've been trying to get a divorce. It was all arranged for, and then she refused to go through with it.
Oh, I don't believe you.
You must believe me.
Please.
Sue. Now, don't be that way, please. We'll get around this somehow. Suppose I have a wife. We can still go on.
I've been waiting for that. What do you think I am anyway? I'd never gone out with you if I'd known you were married. You don't want me. You want a girl you can pay off when you get through with her. I've just made a fool of myself, wiring my people I was coming home to get married. Well, I'm going to California anyway, and you keep away from me, or I'll introduce you to Mrs. Borden.
Sue, wait a minute.
Pardon me. Who was the gentleman that just went out?
Why, that is Mr. Walcott.
What sort of looking person is his wife?
Why, I couldn't say, madam. I just came on duty.
Thank you. Sleeping tablet.
Huh. You scared me.
Why, you didn't think...
I don't know what I thought.
They're perfectly harmless. I've taken loads of them. Put you to sleep in a jiffy.
Well, look. Let me have one, will you? No use my staying awake if you're gonna sleep. A nightcap. sleep peacefully in the arms of Morpheus. Lucky Morpheus.
Here, you better take this too.
Thanks, but...
That's all right, I got something else.
Wake us up in the middle of the night to tell us that?
Great man, Eastman. Put a Kodak in every hole.
Sure. I think I'll get out and stretch my leg.
Don't stretch your tongue. It's working overtime as it is.
So why don't you put your foot where it belongs?
If I did, you wouldn't sit down for a week.
Well, thank goodness I got a sense of humor, friend.
You know, fate seems to have thrown us together.
Sure. Jim told me about you. You're a gorgeous hunk of stuff.
You ought to change your oil every 500 miles.
No. I'm on the level.
Mm-hmm. The lower level.
Next stop, Niagara Falls.
Oh, Niagara Falls. The home of wood pulp, paper, shredded wheat, biscuits, and the world's greatest cataract.
Ooh, I had one in my eye once.
There's an average of over 50 deaths here a year. Poor souls who are either suicides or pushed into the cold waters of the falls.
That gives me an idea.
I'll show you where Blondin in 1864 crossed on a tightrope just to entertain the Prince of Wales. Right over there, folks, where Blondin stretched his cable. He crossed blindfolded with feet fastened on his feet. And over here, the Canadian Falls, where Mrs. Willard and her pet dog made their plunge in a barrel.
The barrel was picked up in a whirlpool. The dog was alive and kicking. Mrs. Willard was dead. Sick transit, Gloria.
How's about us doing a little sick transit, Gloria? I've got two tickets for a boat ride on the Maid of the Mist.
Well, thanks a lot, but I've got a date.
Is Mr. Winthrop?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I couldn't have you stand him up. He's well.
Millions and millions of gallons of water goes over those falls every second.
What's to prevent it?
Well, you seem to be enjoying it all right. But where's your young friend? I haven't seen him.
That's why I'm enjoying it. He had a date with that Fleming girl, and while he was getting bathed and perfumed, I stole his clothes.
Mr. Winthrop would enjoy this.
I wouldn't trust that guy. He's just a wolf in folks' clothing.
Hi, baby.
Oh!
Shh. I'm a stowaway.
Where did you get that coat?
I'm breaking it in for a duck. It's beastly weather we're having, isn't it?
Good weather for ducks.
Ducks? That makes it foul weather.
Oh, look. Isn't the gorge beautiful?
Huh?
I said, isn't the gorge beautiful?
Oh, the gorge is gorgeous. You know, nice place to come for a honeymoon, Niagara. Ever have one?
Have what?
A honeymoon.
Oh. Have you?
Sure. I have all my honeymoons here.
You bring your wife?
Certainly not. Why take French fried potatoes to Paris?
Aren't you going to return your coat?
Oh, well, no. You see, well, I like it. It's a little tight, but we Winthrops do things in a big way.
That fellow over there is trying to get away with the coat.
All right, lad, take off that raincoat. Come on now, I got no time for playing about. Take it off instant.
But I can't.
Oh, Norman, don't be silly. Take off the coat.
But I can't.
Don't let him get away with that, matey.
You're blamed right, I am. Take it off or I'll yank it off.
Well, you do and you'll be sorry.
And I'm going to yank it.
Go on, now get it off, matey. Go on, get that coat off of me.
Do you think he'll be all right?
Sure. I'll introduce you to the driver that follows me, and he'll introduce you to the driver that follows him, and the first thing you know, you'll be in California.
Hiya, Mac.
Here you are. Say, Shorty, you know my friend May?
Thanks for the tip. How are you, May?
Ask him.
Not bad. I'm sorry, Mac. I can't deadhead any dames this trip. There's liable to be a spotter on the run.
Okay. Good luck.
Come on.
Fate had thrown you up with a driver.
Oh, you know how it is. A girl traveling alone has to be taken care of.
Now, you just stick around Miss Bronson's little boy, Willie. You're just the kind of a girl to fit right under my wing.
Oh, when do we have our first fitting?
There you go, Mark.
I didn't ask for no water.
I know, but water's good for you.
That's a third slug today you give me.
Murphy.
Yeah, the water on this bus don't taste so good.
Yeah, it's the Middle West, you know. Flat country, flat water. Come on, drink up. I'm going to keep him snoring all the way to California.
Norman, look.
May I hold him a while? Your arm's
a little... I'm all right, miss.
Please let me hold him. Or is him a her?
Oh, it's a boy. James Delano, Roosevelt, O'Shaughnessy.
Now, James Delano. Good to be here. Behave yourself.
You handle that youngster as if you own one.
Just instinct, mister. Just instinct. I'd love to have a dozen.
Huh?
Sure, who wouldn't?
That's all I wanted to know.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. You hold him for a while.
What, me?
Sure, come on, hold him. Come on.
Guys, baby. Oh, boy, oh, kid.
Oh, you hold him like a banjo.
Careful, friend. Remember the downtown flood.
You better let me take him.
Is he going to meet his father?
No. I'm going back home to my folks. His father left him when he was 4 weeks old.
Left this beautiful baby?
Terrible.
You should think a woman would kill a man who did a thing like that.
I did.
Chicago, 3 hour stopover.
Chicago, folks, the home of the stockyards. You can't miss it. My mistake, folks, my mistake. It's this man's pipe. Friend, why didn't you wait till you got off the bus before you lighted that pipe? It stinks.
So does your oratory.
Whee! Some shower.
Bradley, come in yet? Yes, Miss Winthrop. He's in the next room.
Hand me that robe, will you, please?
All right, sir.
There you are. Okay, we're all set.
Everything's all right, sir.
You take care of those clothes for me and get my other ones ready. Please.
After 2 days in lunch counters, I thought a little real food wouldn't hurt it. Come on in. Take your wraps off.
Where's your keeper?
Oh, Mer?
Well, he's downstairs getting a shave. In fact, I'm waiting for him in the lobby.
Oh, I thought you were broke.
My credit's good.
Good? It's positively.
There, you lovely thing. Let me look at you.
What a beautiful dress. Tattoo?
Yes, the tattoo doesn't know it. This is a tattoo model by Sussman and Goldberg. The dress house with a smile. I haven't worn a tattoo since I stopped modeling.
Model? Where did you model?
Wendell's, 57th Street.
I knew I'd seen you somewhere before. Don't you remember me? I practically paid the rent.
Of course. You were in last spring with a cute little straw blonde. And was she particular? Nothing but real lace. I had to model the scanties.
Well, no wonder. I didn't know you with your clothes on. Your perfume is such an encouragement to deep breathing. Well, you're the loveliest thing.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. I'm not going to let you add me to your collection.
Oh, I was through collecting the minute I met you.
Mean it?
Sure.
I don't like being rushed like this. We're having fun. Don't spoil it.
You're right. I apologize. Hello.
Oh. I beg your pardon. Am I too early?
Early? What are you doing here?
Why, the whole busload's here.
What?
Trout frozen in cucumber aspic.
Boy, am I gonna do some interior decorating.
Mert, what's the idea? I just didn't want you and Miss Fleming to get lonely.
Oh, murder you.
Our young ho. Mighty nice of you to invite us all, Winthrop.
So glad you could all come.
Gather around, friends. Come around now, we're gonna have a toast. Come on, everybody. Well, to our genial young host, epicurus in the guise of Chesapeake.
Don't mind if I do.
Votre santé.
What's that?
That's supposed to be French.
Oh, the only French I know is from that song, Au Fuit de Zay.
Let me tell you something. You were the only thing on the bus that looked good to him. That's why he went for you. And he'll drop you as he has plenty of others.
Think so?
Suppose I were to tell him about us.
Why? Come on, Sue. We've got company.
Well, did you find them all there?
Yes, I never entertained such a bunch in my life.
You do meet odd people on these buses.
I'll say.
You know, it would be interesting to know the background of each one.
I know a lot about some of the people on the bus already.
I know a lot of things about Miss Fleming that I'm afraid she wouldn't care to have you know.
For instance?
Why,
Well, Mr. Winthrop,
this is a fine way to treat your guests. We're all famished.
What were you saying, Gordon?
Nothing, only, Miss Fleming was just telling me that,
What?
If she didn't get something to eat pretty soon,
excuse me. Excuse me. Well, I'll ring right up. Go on inside, won't you? He's right about meeting strange people on the bus. You know how he makes his money?
No.
A crook, working the old Bible racket. I caught him at it in Cleveland.
Bible racket.
Sure. Takes names from the obituary notices and trades on the bereavement of grief-stricken relatives.
So that's how he makes his money. That's awful.
Come on, dear. Drink up. We better get inside before they miss the silverware.
Champagne. My, what a sumptuous repast. And right on the very spot where Mrs. O'Leary's cow kicked the lamp over and burned Chicago.
Well, listen, that's enough champagne here to put that fire out.
Well, a toast, friend.
I'm sorry to interrupt your party, Mr. Winthrop. This is very embarrassing.
What's the trouble?
We've just been informed that your father has stopped your credit.
What of it, Bradley? Put it on the cuff, I'll pay you.
I'm afraid we can't do that, Mr. Winthrop. You know what the hotel business has been. Unless, of course, we could have your check.
Well, no, that's all right. Let me go.
Well, folks, I'm awfully sorry, but afraid the party's off.
Come, let's have a toast. To the ladies, bottoms up. A toast.
Child's restaurant from toast to toast. The sun is about setting on the Mississippi River. Music, and just at the proper moment. Sing up, sister.
Trouble, driver.
The engine's been missing for the last 4 or 5 miles, and I'm stopping here where I can get some help.
Anything serious?
No, but it may hold us up about an hour.
Oh. Well, friend, we're hung up for a while with engine trouble. Let's go to the carnival and stretch your legs. Tired or asleep.
Hooray. Creeping paralysis.
Give me back my $5.
Six in a row, eh?
Would you like to try it?
I never shot a gun in my life.
Oh, you ought to have one for your hope chest.
You've done okay, Buffalo Bill. Why don't you try the bow and arrow?
Oh, me? Oh, no. I never shot a bow and arrow in my life.
You ought to have one for your hope chest.
All right, Smarty. We'll try the bow and arrow.
Tell you what I'll do.
I'll shoot you for a kiss.
Do you have to shoot me for one?
Well, you put me on my best behavior and make it very difficult for me.
I'll tell you what I'll do. If you get a better score than I do, I'll surrender without even a struggle.
It's a bet.
Okay, it's a bet.
You're not very anxious to be kissed, are you?
Well...
Raise your sight.
Hey, you keep that up and you're going to cut yourself out of a lot of fun. It's my last chance.
Yes, you're doing fine.
Yes.
Next time, why don't you hold the arrow and let the bow fly?
What's the matter?
I nearly swallowed the prize.
A ring. Fate. You know?
Fate seems to have thrown us together. Come, my pretty pigeon. You know, when I'm with you, my pulse quickens, my temperature rises, and my heart flutters.
Sounds like an organ recital.
I like this better than the Blackstone.
You're just being nice about it.
No, really. The trees, the moonlight, and it's all so unexpected.
You don't even like to dance with me.
You know I don't care for dancing.
You don't care to do anything that I like.
Oh, let up. You've been ragging me ever since we started on this trip.
Norman, look.
I'm a great devotee of terpsichore.
You better keep your mind on your dancing.
You know, my pretty pigeon, I used to be a great tap dancer.
You mean toe dancer.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Pidgey. Shall we continue dancing?
You dance, and I'll walk around with you.
Oh.
You took my lead.
Lovely doesn't describe it.
Now what?
Well, I guess I'd better get a little further away from you. Because you're altogether too tempting.
What am I?
You love to torment me, don't you? You know I'm dying to kiss you.
No.
You don't want to be kissed?
No.
You don't trust me?
No. Oh, Norman, why start something you can't finish?
But we love each other, don't we? Well, don't we?
I wish I could be more sure.
Of yourself?
Of you. Please. What's the use? I'd grow so fond of you, I'd die if you ever left me.
Oh, Sue. No, we can't meet and part without knowing each other. Be something sweet to remember as long as we live. Now, let me kiss you.
Turned on full. Do the best you can until we get to Denver in the morning.
Hey, I don't want no more water. Say, what's going on here? What day is it?
It's wash day, Merv.
Well, I hope this water doesn't take the give out of my girdle.
I think that driver's looking at us through his mirror.
Driver, will you please quit looking at us through your mirror?
That's all right, lady. I'm an art student.
Steve, throw me that towel. Oh, it's soaking wet. You don't care if I get pneumonia.
No,
no such luck.
I'll never forget this trip as long as I live. If I live.
Lucky you brought these towels.
Lucky we went to the Blackstone.
Oh, Sue, you better have some of this before you catch cold.
What is it?
Whiskey.
Make it two and a ham on rye.
Oh, these are just ruined. I'll have to get some new things when we get to Denver.
There's a swell department store there. Dog.
Denver's best.
Get anything you want. I once picked up an elk there that lasted me 2 years.
Seats on the bus turned around, we could play bridge. If we could play bridge.
I have to do some shopping.
Uncle Wiggins.
Oh, no, Uncle. I'll meet you at the bus terminal. Bye. Could I show you something, Miss?
Hello. Well, what are you doing here?
I don't want to talk to you.
Well, I want to talk to you. Now, please, it's very important.
But I don't want to be seen with you.
Thank you very much. Look here, let's go here. No one will see us.
But I don't want to talk to you.
No, I've been waiting all day to get an opportunity of saying something to you. No, please.
Oh, I wish you'd please let me alone.
Things can't go on this way. Right on the same bus with you. I can't even speak with you.
I didn't create the situation.
Sit down, dear, please.
Oh.
Sue, darling, now I'll take all the blame. You know how I feel about you, or I wouldn't be chasing you all over the country. I'm mad about you.
There's no use discussing it. You've got a wife, and that's that.
Don't you care for me at all?
How could I?
Sue, I'm crazy about you. There isn't anything in the world that I wouldn't do to make you happy.
I'm happy now, and if you do care for me, you won't do anything to spoil it. This is serious.
What a unique place for a rendezvous. And you never saw this girl before.
Nita, wait a minute.
It's about time I caught up with you two.
There's nothing wrong between us.
No?
No.
Then why did you register at that hotel in Albany as James Wolcott and wife?
Did you do that?
I just wanted someplace where we could talk undisturbed.
And I only went there to tell him I wanted nothing more to do with him.
I don't believe a word of it.
Suit yourself.
Wait a minute. Get out of here, you little...
Nita. Now, darling, you're not going to let a little thing like this upset you, are you? You know how men are. I just thought I'd have some fun. That girl means nothing to me. After all, darling, you're my wife. And it was just one of those things, that's all.
Steve. You're not fooling me one bit.
Come right in here. Now, that's the typecart I was telling you about. Pardon me. Something for you?
Yes, I was just admiring these, bows and arrows.
Oh, that's a peach. You ought to feel the pull of it. 40 pounds. Try it.
Thanks.
We sell quite a few of those for hunting. You could kill a grizzly bear with one of these.
I'll say.
They're $36. Pardon me. That top is $14.98. And the main feature, the mattress, is waterproof.
If you think you're going to get away with this, you're crazy.
Oh, now listen, if that's the way you feel about it, why don't we call the whole thing off?
And let you throw me over for a younger woman? I'd like to see myself. I knew something like this was going on. You wanted me to stay at home. You didn't want me to take this trip. Said I'd be uncomfortable. Well, I've been uncomfortable, all right. But not as uncomfortable as you're going to be.
Wait a minute.
I've worked every cheap, mean, petty racket your crooked brain could think of so that you could step out. Well, here's where Mrs. Borden steps out. I've got enough on you to send you up for the rest of your life, but I'm going to do it.
be very glad to show it to you again.
Thank you. And now about this coat. Do you think it'll fit a man about your size?
I'm quite sure it will.
Then I'll take it. Now, will you show me the cuff, please?
Yes, ma'am. And remember the main feature. The mattress is waterproof.
But, darling, you've never been camping. You'd enjoy it. The rush of the river, the scent of the pine. Of course, you'd be roughing it. You'd get used to that. And it would be wonderful for the children.
Well, I guess I'll take it. And now I'd like to see the ping pong table.
They're in the basement. I'll be very glad to show them to you.
What's the bell for?
Closing time, Miss.
Closing time? Oh, my goodness, how the day flies.
Thank you, Dad.
Closing time.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Denver to visit some friends.
Oh, he's very lucky. My wives would never allow me out of their sight.
Wives?
Yes, I have three. Blonde, brunette, and tissue.
Oh, a wholesaler.
No, just a consumer.
That shopping tour took a lot out of you.
What do you mean?
And you're all nervous and fidgety, and I've asked you the same question three times.
I'm sorry, Norman. What was it?
Just asked if you loved me as well.
Please.
How was that?
Lazy man.
Love anyone else?
You're the first one, you know.
I guess the baby needs his medicine.
Sure.
Hello, Borden. You still up?
Yes. Funny, I was just thinking about you.
Me?
Why? Why, well, perhaps I'd better not say anything about it.
No, no. What's on your mind?
Why, it's about you and Sue.
Sue?
Yes, I... Oh, well, forget it.
No, no, let's have it.
I wouldn't say this, only Sue means an awful lot. Even though she has broken off our engagement.
Engagement?
Yes. Didn't she tell you? Oh, I'm so sorry, Harry. Perhaps I shouldn't have said anything about it.
You mean you knew Sue before you got on the bus?
Yes. Oh, yes, she used to work for me. You see, we were engaged to be married. I'd arranged with my wife for a divorce. Then you came in the picture. Sue wouldn't. Of course, I don't blame her. After all, you can probably do a lot more for her than I can. Your family, your position. I don't mind telling you that it sort of knocked me for a loop.
I see.
I don't know what Steve Borden told you, but you believe in me, don't you?
Sure I do. You better go to sleep soon.
Oh, sleep. How can I sleep when you treat me like this?
Here. This will put you to sleep.
Lay off, Dave. I'll be glad when we get up to the lumber camp. The only woman up there is the cook, and he's a Chinaman.
We're pulling into Salt Lake City, folks. Salt Lake.
Salt Lake City, folks, the home of the Mormon. See the great Mormon temple, a symphony in stone. Great man, Brigham Young. Had 20 wives, always slept with his grandfather.
How many wives did you say, Senator?
20, my child, 20.
Oh, there's a man that can take a streetcar in any direction and always get home.
Me a bit if we run into a blizzard. Boy, I never been so hot in my life. I feel like I'm sitting on a blowtorch.
Pardon me, Mr. Glover. I have a customer who wants a cigar stand like the one we have in the window, and there's none in stock.
Well, take the one in the window.
Yes, Mr. Glover.
Still living in the wide open spaces. I want to see. There's nothing on this desk. That's a great phrase. You gotta remember that.
Is this the bus left tender at 6:45 Saturday night?
Yes.
Well, get all your passengers out.
Everybody out, please. Come on. Is that a schoolhouse over there, Sergeant?
Okay, Chief.
Do you mind all going over to that schoolhouse? All of you. I want to ask some questions.
Come on.
Right over there.
What's the matter, officer?
Come on, come on. Right over in that schoolhouse.
Yes, I'm Mr. Borden. When did you get on the bus, Mr. Borden? New York City. Alone? No, my wife was with me. Is Mrs. Borden here? No, Mrs. Borden stopped off to visit some friends in Denver. I don't see why.
Wait a minute, please, all of you. Now, Mr. Borden, if you or any of you refuse to answer my questions, I'll be obliged to take you all back to Denver for questioning. Mr. Borden, are you happily married?
Yes, very.
Did you want to say something, lady?
Nothing. Only he and Mrs. Borden had one quarrel, and it lasted all the way from Chicago to Denver.
Yeah? What were they quarreling about?
Well, if you ask me, I dare say the poor woman had plenty to complain about.
Yeah, go on.
I heard Mr. Borden tell Mr. Winthrop that he was divorcing his wife and was going to marry Miss Fleming.
Which is Miss Fleming?
I'm Miss Fleming.
Mr. Winthrop?
I'm Mr. Winthrop.
Borden,
are you divorcing your wife?
Well, we were arranging for a divorce, yes.
He just said they were happily married.
I don't see why we're stopped this way and subjected to all this cross-questioning.
Now, wait a minute. Is that your wife? Borden, your wife is dead. Murdered.
Murdered?
All marks of identification were removed from her clothing, and her body placed in the window with three wax figures playing bridge.
She was a dummy.
Your wife's picture was recognized by the driver who brought the bus into Denver. That's how we found you. Miss Fleming, when did you last see Mrs. Borden?
Saturday afternoon at Dodd's department store, in the tent.
In the tent? It's kind of an odd place for a meeting, isn't it?
Mrs. Borden had evidently been following her husband, for she walked in almost immediately and discovered us.
Well, that must have been very embarrassing, Miss Fleming. Do you mind telling me just what happened?
Nothing happened. Mrs. Borden was furious, and I left them calling.
Just a moment, please. May I refresh your memory? It was I who walked out and left you and Mrs. Borden discussing the divorce.
Why, that's a lie.
Did you ever shoot a bow and arrow?
Bow and arrow? I? Oh, never.
How about you, Miss Fleming?
She's an expert. Back there in an amusement park, I saw her put some arrows in a bullseye quicker than you could say Jack Robinson.
She means William Dale.
Shh. Why, yes, I use a bow and arrow. Why?
Mrs. Borden was shot in the back with an arrow.
An arrow?
The broken shaft was still in her body. Miss Fleming, I shall have to take you into custody.
What? Well, I didn't kill her. What? I had no quarrel with her. I didn't want her husband.
I'm sorry, Miss Fleming.
But I didn't do it. I couldn't. I wouldn't do such a thing. Oh, you've got to believe me. You've got to.
Sergeant, get the names and addresses.
That guy Borden is lying.
Now, you keep out of this, kid.
Why are you standing like a dope for? Ain't you gonna... Sue told me that she don't give a hang about Borden. She was only...
Now, here's the main floor. This is the sporting goods department. Here's the window where the body was found.
There's the tent where the murder was committed.
How far is it from the tent to the window?
About 100 feet, more or less.
Then if the murder was committed in the tent, the murderer had to remain in the store after it closed in order to carry the body to this point and dress the window, you might say?
Exactly.
Well, Mr. Borden, when you worked in a department store, ever dress any windows?
What? That was his job when I first met him.
Better get all that down, Sergeant.
Yes, Sergeant.
Officer, you say the body was found in the show window with the arrow broken off. Were there any fingerprints?
All carefully removed.
You mind if I speak with Miss Fleming a moment?
No, go ahead.
I wonder if I can find a bow and arrow anyway. Come on. Say, you use them bow and the arrow?
I beg your pardon, sir.
Among my people, the bow and arrow became obsolete with the passing of the buffalo.
Oh, well, I'm so sorry.
It's quite all right, sir.
Well, do you think you could find me a bow and arrow?
The chief's in Mahukabi.
No.
My grandfather may have one.
Oh, please. Officer, would you accompany me outside for a moment, please? I'd like Miss Fleming to come, too.
All right, Miss Fleming. Sergeant, see if the rest of the passengers stay here.
Officer, I don't see what can be gained by this delay. These are all matters that can be taken up at the trial. After all, my wife has been murdered. I'm very anxious to get back to Denver.
Take it easy, Mr. Borden.
Thank you very much.
You're quite welcome.
Now, Miss Fleming, I want you to shoot an arrow into that beef over there.
Say, you better get these people out of the way.
What guy?
Don't worry, she won't miss it.
What you going for?
Very good. Muy bien. Muy bien.
Come along, officer. Now, officer, would you mind removing that arrow for me, please? I guess you'd have to break it off, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I guess I would.
Miss Fleming, let's see if you can get that out.
The expert archer never tries to pull the arrow out when it's stuck in the object. He pushes it through. Like this.
Thank you. I guess we can go back now, that's all.
Here they come.
Borden, did you say that you never shot a bow and arrow?
That's exactly what I said, officer, yes.
Why?
Officer, that's just the point. This crime was committed by someone unfamiliar with archery. Otherwise, the arrow would not have been broken off. Now, that's the first. Second, the murderer was thoroughly familiar with department store routine. He knew that the body, if left in the tent, would be quickly discovered. But if placed in the window, which in most stores are changed weekly, he'd have plenty of time to escape. Third, to open the door to the show window, lower the front shade, and arrange the body quickly and naturally could only be the work of an expert window dresser. This man, Borden, is a professional window dresser. He is not an expert archer and so had to break the arrow off. He wanted that girl. His wife wouldn't give him a divorce, so the only way to get rid of her was to kill her. Now, I demand that you arrest him for the murder of his wife.
Look here, officer. If you're going to attach any importance to this amateur sleuth, this partial investigation, I suggest that the sooner you get to bat, the better.
Driver, get your bus started.
I agree with you, Mr. Borden. This is a matter for the district attorney.
I'll hold all you passengers as material witnesses until the bus gets to Reno.
Come on, get going.
minute.
Just a minute. Wait a minute.
Come on. Everybody here, Sergeant?
They're all here, Chief.
All right. Get in, Mr. Fleming, please. Mr. Borden? Come on, everybody. Inside here.
Oh, Steve, what are you doing?
Get going.
Wait a minute, that won't do anything.
What about the
plane? That's it. We'll overtake them in the plane and block them off. Come on.
Good. Yeah. Oh, get out of that seat.
No.
Give me that wheel.
You're crazy, Borden. You can't drive this bus.
Get out of that seat.
You all right, Winthrop?
I hope so.
Looks like you're finished, Borden. Come on, boys, get him out.
Afraid of me being too old, my pretty pigeon.
Trust me, Senator. I'll put you back on your feet.
Mr. William Ronson?
That's me all, we're friends.
You're wanted. For bigamy.
Bigamy?
A short life, but a merry one, my pretty pigeon. The best laid plans of mice and men. But you're young, your life's before you. Be happy. Be optimistic.
Try and talk yourself out of that.
Come on, Mark.
Now, where were you?
I had to say goodbye to Miss Fleming.
Well, I'm sure glad to get rid of that dame. Dames get you into more trouble.
I know, I know. Is the luggage on board?
Sure.
Well, let's get up to the lumber car.
To have thrown us together.
Mm-hmm.